Hello everyone, Adrian here. Recently I was asked to create something to commemorate 5th anniversary of Joshua English School. The idea was to use only wood, but after taking some consideration, I've came with the idea of using acrylic glass. And as you will see, this was rather a pretty good idea, especially combined with the Bluetooth controlled RGB LEDs and wooden base. To start, all I had was this rather low quality JPEG file with the school logo. There is a plenty of compression artifacts that we need to clean up. The idea is to trace this image with Inkscape and use SVG file with VCart or Fusion. Usually I use color threshold tool in GIMP to create black and white image. First of all, we should change the image to grayscale. This way threshold works best. And as you can see, we still have all those nasty artifacts. But by just increasing the contrast, we can get rid most of them, and now threshold tool works just fine. All we need is to find the proper black and white balance. Everything looks nice, but because I've already done that, I know that this English school text is not going to look perfect after tracing, and that's why I'll cut out this one and prepare a sample to find the font that will look exactly the same. There is probably a lot of other web pages with the same functionality. I use occasionally this one. You just need to upload image with the sample text and the engine will match most likely font from the database. Usually it's fully automated and you do not need to even mark text area, especially if you prepare it like we did. Below you can see matched fonts and you just need to choose one and download it. Okay, this is our final bitmap image that we need to trace now. I use as much open source tools as possible and Inkscape is one of them with pretty nifty tracing algorithm. Just drag and drop image and choose the trace bitmap. Since we already provided black and white image, threshold value here is almost not important and we can leave default value. Just click OK. And now we have two objects. One is our original bitmap image and another one is the new traced one vector image. For the time being, we stick with both of them to have a text size reference. Just to make you see what I was talking about with problematic English school text after tracing, here you can see how bulky and uneven it is. Because of that, we are going to remove traced text and replace it with freshly installed font text. This is really nice font, sadly not the one we wanted here. Because we can see the size of the text on the bitmap layer below, we can now scale out our new fonts properly. Now I can delete obsolete bitmap image. And because this object is still a text written font, for engraving, we need to convert it to splines with object to path tool. Like you can see, all those letters are now splines paths. Group all separate objects, scale it down a bit, and this is going to be our final SVG file to use it with VCarve. Now switching to Windows, I used VCarve to prepare G-code for engraving and cutting acrylic. Later I've used LightBurn to do the laser engraving and the Fusion for wood cutting, but for the sake of this tutorial I'll focus only on acrylic part. First we need to define our material. Partly because of my CNC machine sizes, I've chosen acrylic plate to be 26 cm width and 80 cm long, with 6 mm thickness. My machine has home plates on the lower left corner. I started with defining shape for cutting our final board. This is going to be rectangle with slightly rounded upper corners, but we can't define here only one pair of corners to be rounded. So we use a small merging trick. And the reason why I want straight edges on the lower part is because this way light from LED strips will be dispersed better on the left and right edge. After creating a first shape, we can create a small rectangle with the same width but smaller height. This one has straight edges. Now we can merge those two rectangles and the result is going to be required shape. Time to import our SVG image. Because VCarve import it as a separate objects, first we should group them together. Then some sizing and placing in the middle. We can use proper tool to place it exactly in the middle. And finally, because I want the engraving to be on far side of the plate, I think it look better this way, we need to flip it horizontally. Now it's time to prepare our G-code for CNC machine. I've used a small spindle with 3.175 mm collet that came with the machine because I did not have proper bits for a bigger Makita rotor yet. I did quite a lot of tests on a different acrylic materials to find the proper depth, spacing and speed for V-cut. All the DVD, CD acrylic cases were quite useful here. I've used extruded acrylic, which is less heat resistant, and general rule is to use cast acrylic for all routing purposes. But I've used what I had. First we will define our cut with the small 3.175 mm end bit. Depth and speed values here are proper for my router, and they may not work for you. You should try it first on some scraps. You need to cut it fast enough not to melt acrylic, but slow enough to create clean cut. In this case I'm cutting 0.5 on each pass, so for 6mm material it gives 12 passes. Since my plate is fixed on the working table with a double side adhesive tape, I can do the full cut without the tabs. Now you need just to choose the proper vector shape to cut and generate path. This is the preview of the cut. Despite we define it first, cutting should be done after engraving. Engraving is going to be done with narrow 20 degree V-bit, also with 3.175 mm shaft. Now crucial here is to get the proper depth of the cut. It depends on your equipment, speed of the spindle and mostly of the dust evacuation method. You simply need something to clean the working area. Best way is to flush all the dust with compressed air. I've used a 3D printed fan mounted on the spindle collet. Although it's usually enough to clean wood, it was not enough with acrylic. If you fail to clean working area, dust may melt down and settle on the working bit in the shape of big acrylic blob, covering completely cutting edge, and this is game over. In best case you will just ruin your surface, in the worst case scenario you have ruined your surface and broke your bit. So in this case I've came out with a depth of 0.15mm and the same step over value and filled engraving with cross hatched movement. The step over value is the distance between each pass of the bit, so it should match your size of the tip or be close to it. Just remember, we do not want to clean surface here. It should be as rough as possible, but in a consistent way, so it will nicely disperse the light. There is no real preview here, I guess it's because of this tiny depth of engraving, but when you look at the head movement, it will let you know if everything is as it should be. So let's start engraving. Thank you. you can see all those white regions are because of a dirty bead. Acrylic dust has melted and settled on a V-bead, making it dull. The only good solution I found is to dust working area with compressed air. It works great, but you have to be on the place all the time. I'm planning to do automated duster later on with Arduino and pressure valve. Some kind of a small remedy can be a wooden stick pressed against the working bit. It helps to clean it up, but it works only in early stage of a blob. But anyway, you can clean a bit and make another pass, hoping it will clean everything up. This cut concludes acrylic part of the project, and this is just a test how engraving acrylic will look with the LED strips underneath. I think it looks pretty cool. Now I've designed wooden base made of two pieces of wood, front plate with the laser etched text and the bottom one with a slot for RGB LED stripe, Bluetooth controller and some lead weight to make it more stable. LED strip is short enough to be fully powered over USB cable.